This is the boat landing at Birch Island Lake. This is the start of the trails of the Hanscom Lake Trail. It goes in right across the road over there through to the boat landing on Hanscom Lake. We had volunteers go through and cut a lot of the dead and down trees that were across the trail. Steve had a gentleman come along later with us that used some of the wood, and he also did a nice job of cutting some of the trees in order to help it become 10 feet wide. On the right here, we can see that this is Peck's property. This is not Voyager. On the other side, we've got private property. The entire trail is about a mile and a half. This section of the trail has been used by the deer proficiently in the winter. I've seen as many as 15 deer when I've been grooming this section of the trail. Here the trail runs into a T. When you look to the left here, this is a spur that goes out across the road to the ski trail that's on number 6. When you go right at the T, you go along the boundary fence here east, and the area to my left here is common property that has been logged off by the loggers. They took a lot of dead and down popple out of this area. The trail goes north, paralleling Long Lake Road for a quarter of a mile. The trail leaves Long Lake Road and heads west. I tried to walk this part of the trail after the storm, and it looked like this, like you see. This is not on our property, this is a neighbor's property, but you can see what the storm left us. This is another area that was really hard hit by the storm. The trail is great for walking, but for grooming, and it will be necessary to mow it when the popple shoots and other vegetation start coming up, and it would be nice to have it a little smoother for our mowing. Here's the north end of the trail. It ends at the Hanscom Lake boat landing, and it goes in right there by those birch trees.